And welcome to this interview on money control. Joining me on this interview is my colleague Priyanka Iyer, and we are in conversation with Yashish Dahiya, the chairman and CEO of PB FinTech, which listed with a 17% premium today. And PB FinTech, of course, is the parent of Policy Bazaar as well as Paisa Bazaar. Yashish, first of all, congratulations. One of your oldest friends, Hitesh Oberoi, tweeted a while ago that, you know, he's known you for 33 years. And if it was anyone else, they would have given up a long time ago and gone back to London. So he said, Iron Man managed to do it. What does this milestone personally mean for you, Yashish?
I think we are very happy that, you know, as a team, we managed to stay the course and build what we have. I think it's still very early days. I believe these companies like us, are zero ones. In 10 years from now, either the company will be very strong or the company will not exist. And I think it's very critical that we build an organization that that lasts into the future. So on one side, I feel good that we've come some distance. On the other side, there seem to be some very clear plans on how we build for the future, and very excited about those.
Do you think Policy Bazaar was, or PB FinTech rather, was always meant to have a life in the markets? Is that how you always envisioned it through all the struggles and pivots and changes that you've had to make over the last decade?
I think with the number of private equity investors we had over time, it was a logical conclusion that at some point we would have to be public. Being in regulated markets, it's also good for us to be public. So yes, for the last, and you know, if I look back at our history over the last 20, 25 quarters, we were quite okay in terms of being able to, you know, guide our investors. Yes, of course, there are surprises in any business, but the surprises are not that high, if I could use that term. So we felt we were ready now. And yes, the destination forever has been being on the public markets. If you ask me honestly why, I wouldn't have a very clear answer for why we wanted to be public, except for the fact that, like, it was the next step. It was like, you know, after you do class 12, you know, you don't know what to do next. And somebody says, okay, become an engineer. Somebody says, do an MBA after that. So I guess it's a bit of that. So we kind of became public. But the reasons for why we become public are not very clear in my mind, except for the fact that, yes, our investors all seem to be very happy that we're a public company now.
Right. Yashish. So, Yashish, you know, before the listing happened, you have also reduced the size of your offer for sale. You as well as Alok, you all have reduced that size. We understand it comes from the confidence that you have in the company that you have built, and you believe that it's going to give a lot more returns in the future. So how do you see this going forward? Will you all be looking at reducing your shareholding at a later stage, maybe?
I'll explain a bit to you, and maybe you would appreciate this. A large part of our shareholding is in the form of ESOPs. And every time the ESOPs come due, there is a tax due on them at 43%. And that tax has to be paid in advance of us selling our shares. And, you know, there can be some challenges around that. And for that, we need money. So we had to, plan to sell something to make sure that we were prepared to pay the tax. Now, when Alok and I discussed, our worry was that if we sell now and we pay taxes later, what happens if the price fluctuates, whether up or down? You know, either we would have sold a lot. So you get the story, right? Both ways, we would have been kind of, it doesn't make sense to sell shares and keep money to pay taxes, which are going to be due in the future. We would rather, sell those shares and collect that money just when the taxes are going to be due. And that's the thinking. So, I think sometime in the year, we will have some transactions, and we've been quite clear about that. We cannot pay the tax by ourselves. That's obvious, right? There's going to be, lot of taxes to be paid, hundreds of crores, and that money has to be arranged.
Right. Yashish, the last time we spoke, you said profitability is a choice. But now that you are a listed company, you will be scrutinized quarter to quarter. And, you know, even a mild fall or an increase in losses is not something that investors take very well to. So how are you going to balance this need to make investments, aggressively grow out your offline presence with the need to also, you know, evaluate a path to profitability? I mean, your losses have halved, but how are you going to build on that?
No, absolutely. I think I have been crystal clear in all my communication to at least all the investors I've met, and I've met about 150 investors. Each person I have been crystal clear to, and I'm crystal clear here as I'm communicating to investors, we are not going to be short-term profit-focused. Now, that doesn't mean we're going to be inefficient or wasteful. You look at the history of our organization. We've raised $150 million and built two companies out of that, Policy Bazaar and Paisa Bazaar. And so that is about $70 million has gone a piece to building a consumer brand on the internet in India, which by today's terms is a decent outcome. You know, of course, times keep changing. So we are going to be sensible. Being overly frugal can be hurtful to the brand in the long term, and that is not our intent. Now, our core business is and has been profitable for a while. Those are, you know, basically your core insurance and your core lending businesses. However, there are lots of experiments we do, and we will keep doing them because my job here, see, now nobody has given us this valuation to deliver profits today or even tomorrow. This valuation is for what we are going to build out in the next 5 years, 10 years. And my entire focus is on that. And I have obviously, you know, I have a good sense for where that business ends up in terms of profitability in 5 years' time. And that's quite encouraging. But whether we are profitable next year or the year after, I have not given any guidance to any of our investors who think that, when I've also, in fact, warned them not to have any such expectations, because I will not be driven by that. We have a core business which will get more and more efficient with time, but our experiments will continue as required, because our job, as I said, is not to protect the present. It's to make sure that we are relevant in the future. And that's the most critical job that I have.
Right. Yashish, talking about your core business, if you can now tell us probably a little more in terms of the milestones that you have set internally for the credit business as well as for the insurance business. Of course, there's a lot of penetration and possibilities there. But in terms of your realistic expectations over the next few years, in terms of customer addition, how many more insurance plans you'll disburse, and also how your reach in terms of your offline presence, and on the credit front, in terms of the amount of disbursals that you're looking at.
See, I think we will safely continue to grow at about double the rate of the industry, or at least 20% faster than the industry in every category. That is what I feel. That's what our internal targets are. That's how we peg ourselves. That should be a minimum expectation from us, because being a digital business, I think digital is growing faster. And our focus, etc., on those areas, that's how it's going to be. We're quite satisfied with how it's been in the last couple of years, and we are hungry for more. Let's see. Let's wait and watch. You know, we have very strong plans for the next 5 years. I do not want to be very specific about those, because that's not the right thing for me to do. But of course, in my mind, I'm quite specific. And that is something that is internally shared within our team.
Right. Yashish, one of the objectives for this IPO was also to ramp up your international presence, apart from growing your core business, making, you know, acquisitions and so on. You have a presence in Dubai now. Where else do you see the opportunity or the synergy for a Policy Bazaar? Will it be insurance? Will it be credit? How will you go about it?
No, so let me clarify. There is no immediate plan to expand internationally beyond the UAE. None formalized or unformalized. There is no clear plan. There is no country that we have planned for. There are lots of opportunities out there. Europe has almost not transformed in the last 15 years while we've been building Policy Bazaar. 15 years has been static. So there's a lot of opportunity there. And Europe is a very big market. And I deeply understand it. Middle East, you look at Saudi, Turkey, Egypt, put Indonesia in the pack. starts to become a pretty significant opportunity. Again, not decided. Yeah, we are aware of the opportunity. Southeast Asia is another significant opportunity. But again, we're not decided. We may never do anything. We are not extremely keen on it. At this point, our focus is India and building the business for India and strengthening our capabilities in India.
Priyanka?
Yashish, if you can also take us through really, you know, when you have all these plans, even within the country, the expansion plan, what could be the challenges specifically for both credit as well as insurance? What can really come in the way of the innovation and the expansion that you really want to look at?
See, the two strategic challenges I see over the next 2-3 years are on two fronts. One is how the ecosystem evolves on claims. And what that implies is, do the consumers really get an auto-adjudicated experience on claims so that this whole issue of will I get a claim, will I not get a claim is taken out of the picture and a customer gets a very seamless standard service whichever company he buys an insurance policy from. That is a very critical area of development for us. And I think as that happens, it will develop the whole industry. And of course, we will be a beneficiary of that. The second part is customer experience, customer onboarding experience. It's a very, very difficult industry. And of course we have to do a lot of stuff on that. So from, you know, there's tactical stuff, there's strategic stuff. Tactical stuff is things that have already been done or are put in motion and will happen automatically. And then there is strategic stuff or strategic risks, which may or may not happen. So these are the areas I think are of strategic risk areas that I am very, very focused on to make sure that we evolve both as an industry and as a company. In making sure our customers get better experience and the claims handling is better. That applies for credit as well. Even today in credit cards, people have to go and pick up documents, etc. So all that stuff does need to be streamlined. We need to have more of a digital process.
Right. But anything from the regulatory standpoint also you see, because there's insurance as well as credit. So RBI, IRDAI,
I think we have a clear line as far as the regulatory guidances and regulations are concerned. So we are quite happy with those. Of course, we would expect, access to digital lakes to be available to the consumer through whichever window they came from. That's a very critical part of development for the entire country's ecosystem, that these digital lakes that are being built out, the consumer can access their own data from whichever platform they choose, whether it's a policy bazaar, whether it's a XYZ, whether it's an insurance company, whether it's a bank, whoever it is. I think these are all windows for the consumer so that whoever can give the consumer the best experience, the consumer should have the choice to interact with those entities.
Right. Finally, Yashish, what has your biggest takeaway or learning been, you know, from taking your company public, and what are you looking forward to the most as a publicly listed entity?
I think, I never understood these things like HNI liquidity, this, that and the other. It is good I'm coming across these terms. I personally do not have a trader's mentality. I have a builder's mentality. And that's kind of, it's just a mentality. And it's a very important thing to state. I have never invested in anything. I have never invested in a stock. The only thing I built is Policy Bazaar. I'm not an investor in any startup. Simply because I don't have that mentality of, value will increase, etc. I don't think that way. I just think it's something useful to build and then keep building it. So it's been a different experience for me. Quite honestly, I have stayed quite aloof from it. It's Alok who has run the entire IPO process. And we are very lucky to have somebody as strong as Alok and as thought through as him, because he and his team have protected the rest of the company, I would say, from the IPO process. So nobody else in our company really knows that there's a process going on. Of course, they hear about it in the news, but that's it. And I think we are very happy to have that. Yes, it's dawning on us that we have a large responsibility. I was told we have about 1 million people who subscribed and about 4 lakh people who currently hold shares in our company. We are humbled by that responsibility. We are grateful to all those people to believe in us. But besides that, quite honestly, being public and all the values and all don't mean too much to me. There has always been enough for my needs.
Got it. On that note, Yashish, thank you very much for talking to Money Control, and look forward to more conversations.
Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you.